CNN has learned that Robert Mueller's team has questioned this man here, Trump campaign pollster Tony Fabrizio. This news coming, of course, after we learned that Trump's former campaign chairman, Paul Manafort, shared internal campaign data, polling data, with a suspected Russian operative and asked that it be passed on to two pro-Putin Ukrainian oligarchs. So what does this all mean? We have CNN political correspondent Sarah Murray here with us now. What do we know about this meeting that Fabrizio had with the special counsel?
Well, Brianna, we know this meeting actually happened back in February of last year, and CNN journalists actually saw Fabrizio go in for this interview and then later confirmed that he was, in fact, meeting with the special counsel's team. And it was interesting because at the time, prosecutors were looking into Paul Manafort and his Ukrainian business dealings, but they were also looking into what those Ukrainian business dealings may have had to do with collusion. Now, all of this is very interesting now because he was Trump's chief pollster on the campaign, and we're learning this new information about how Paul Manafort shared polling data with a Russian associate. That's caused a lot of alarm among Democrats who are saying, why was Paul Manafort sharing this information? Now, Tony Fabrizio would not comment for the story, but a person who was familiar with his interview said that he was asked about some of the work he had previously done with Paul Manafort in Ukraine. He did some polling for him in 2013 and in 2012, but wasn't asked about proprietary Trump campaign data. What we don't know, though, is what else was covered over the course of this interview. We know that when Mueller brings witnesses in, they tend to be pretty extensive interviews. They tend to cover a lot of ground. So there's still a lot of questions about what they might have wanted with Fabrizio and whether it was campaign related, whether it was solely Manafort related, and, you know, whether there were any follow-up interviews after that.
And what we now know is that, and because of Manafort's attorneys failing to redact something in a filing, an admission that Manafort passed on this proprietary data, as you put it, internal polling data, pretty sensitive stuff, he passed that on. We've also since learned, right, that he was in the hole millions of dollars to an oligarch, mm-hmm. right? So he had some business dealings. He was vulnerable in some ways, at least on one front, and we've learned this.
Yeah, Paul Manafort basically had no money coming in, and he still took a job working on the Trump campaign and didn't accept a salary for taking that job. There were a lot of weird things going on with his finances. It turns out, you know, he had previously been making all of this money with these pro-Russian Ukrainian oligarchs. They still owed him millions of dollars, and a source told CNN that's who he wanted to get the polling data to, these pro-Russian Ukrainian oligarchs. Now, his spokesman denied that this was some kind of quid pro quo polling data in exchange for the money. But I think there are a lot of unanswered questions here about why Paul Manafort felt it was necessary to share this information with a Russian associate that prosecutors say has ties to Russian intelligence, and why he wanted it in the hands of these pro-Russian Ukrainian oligarchs. Now, Democrats are also asking, okay, what did the Russians use this for, and who else knew about it? And President Trump came out today and insisted, I didn't know anything about this. I didn't know Paul Manafort was sharing this information with the Russians.
Yeah, very important point. All right, I want to bring in former federal prosecutor turned defense attorney, CNN legal analyst Shan Wu with us, and associate editor and columnist at Real Clear Politics, A.B. Stoddard. So, Shan, there's a source familiar with the special counsel's interest who says that this man, Tony Fabrizio, was asked about his polling work for Manafort in Ukraine rather than his internal Trump campaign polling. What does that tell you?
It tells us, again, that Mueller's investigation is a little bit ahead of what we know that they know.
And they know. We don't know what they know.
Right, exactly. So looking at the polling means that you can infer at that point they were already curious and suspicious about what kind of internal information might have been going out and what Manafort might have been trying to get out at that point, or at least the campaign. And this whole issue with the polling data is just so curious because one can't imagine any legitimate reasons why a foreign entity would want any kind of polling data. And while Manafort's people, I would expect that they might spin this to say, well, they're asking him just about the work he did for Manafort with the Ukrainian people, obviously that would not be of such great interest to Mueller.
What do you think, AB?
Well, I think that this whole episode is so dramatic for two reasons. One, it's the first time that people can look to an event and say, this really looks like collusion with a foreign government interest, who all of our intelligence agencies have said had it out to beat Hillary Clinton and make sure Trump was elected. And that was the entire goal of their interference in this election. The second one was that we found this out inadvertently. And it means all along people have said, there's no collusion, it would have leaked out. It is an indicator that Mueller might have lots on collusion that we only saw one crumb of inadvertently leak out. And so as Shan points out, and Sarah, I mean, There are so many witnesses that we don't know about. There are so many. There's so much testimony that we don't know about. Now that the House is in control by Democrats, in their investigations, they intend, at the Intelligence Committee intends to turn over a bunch of transcripts that the Republicans refuse to turn over to Mueller. What if he then finds that witnesses have lied to Congress? And what if he can flip them and make this an even longer investigation? I don't think we know what he has, and I don't think that we know that this is about to conclude either.
And the question that people keep wondering, did the president know about this? He was asked about the polling share by Manafort Shan. He said he didn't know about it.
Right.
So how significant is that we now have the president on the record saying he didn't know about it? And if there is no proof that he knew about it or he genuinely didn't know about it, what does that mean?
Well, President Trump's being on the record is a real term of art, unless he's actually under oath. So I think any statements he makes in public, I don't think he would ever feel like he's wedded to those statements.
You don't take to the bank.
I also think we need to remember there's another very important witness in this that is still cooperating who would have known about a lot of this polling information, and that's Rick Gates,
right,
who was your former client and was Paul Manafort's right-hand man. This is someone who is cooperating with Mueller's team, is cooperating in ongoing investigations. So, you know, President Trump can obviously, you know, deny it publicly, but if there was some, certainly if there was any kind of document trail that shows that Trump knew about this during the campaign, you can bet that Mueller's team has that. And you can bet that Rick Gates is talking about it.
A.B., when the president was asked whether this report, let's call it the Mueller report, it was the Star report with Bill Clinton, right, if it should be public. In the past, it has been public. And also members of Congress have had access to underlying findings that didn't even make the report. But the president asked if it should be public. He won't say. What does that tell you?
An interesting response.
Really?
Instead of
why?
No, I have the right to, you know, to exert executive privilege and insist that so much be redacted or removed or blocked, or, you know, he just left it open. I thought that was kind of fascinating that he didn't try to put his foot down, which his lawyers, his brand new team of 17 additional lawyers, certainly intend to do.
Right.
AB, Shan, Sarah, thank you all.